embolism. Pulmonary embolism is an obstruction of the pulmonary artery. It could be saddle. Pulmonary embolism that would be here, obstructing exactly at the branch point, or just a branch. When we have this, we have the increase of the dead space. Dead space is the inspired air that does not have an interchange of gases. So here we have the alveoli, here we have a capillary, but because we have obstruction, the blood cannot go this way, and so we have air that we are breathing that is arriving to the alveoli, but cannot do exchange because we don't have blood. So we have increased dead space, and this is going to result in a VQ mismatch, in a VQ scanning. The pulmonary embolism could be because of fat, air, thrombus, bacteria, amniotic fluid, or tube. The silly mnemonic is fat, bat. Fat, because of the tissue of the bone, could be the bone marrow. Air, because of Caisson disease, for example. Thrombus, a precoagulable state. Bacteria, some infection. Amniotic fluid could be any complication of pregnancy, and any kind of tumor. Alright. If it is fat embolism, usually we have the triad of neurological symptoms, because also the bone marrow that goes out of the long bone, let's say in a fracture. If we fracture some long bone, we have the bone marrow can go to any place, could go to the pulmonary artery, could go to the arteries of the brain, and so the patient has neurological symptoms and the manifestation of pulmonary embolism. And a skin rash. The skin rash is a petechia in the thorax, usually. Alright, so this is the triad: neurological symptoms, skin rash, and the pulmonary embolism. Next, we can have air embolism. This could be Caisson disease. This is when people go very, very deep in the water. When they ascend very quickly, we have bubbles of nitrogen inside the vessels, and so this can go and obstruct the pulmonary artery. The treatment is decompression. They put them in a camera decompression and give O2 hyperbaric oxygen. Could also be because of iatrogenic, for example, we are putting some catheter or something, but we also put air because we did wrong. Could also be. Next would be amniotic fluid. It usually is the complication is that we have DIC. DIC is disseminated intravascular coagulation, but it's rare, but it is a high mortality. It has high mortality. Next tumor, right? Thrombus. Thrombus is the most complicated. Here we have in the vein, we have this thrombus that forms in the deep veins, also could be popliteal artery, iliac arteries, arteries from the plexus of the prostate or ovaries, usually in the deep veins of the leg. So the spreads and go to the vena cava, inferior vena cava, right atrium, right ventricle, and pulmonary artery. So now we have a thrombus in the pulmonary artery. Now, for this patient, we are going to give anticoagulation. Usually it's heparin. Could be normal heparin or heparin of low molecular weight. Usually we give low molecular weight heparin. Also, we prefer to use this in patients with renal failure or pregnant patients. Alright, we give this because the only symptoms we don't want in thrombus embolism is that the thrombus propagate, but we don't want to dissolve the thrombus because the thrombus is going to be dissolved. So for that we don't give antithrombolytic agents. No, we just give anticoagulation. We don't want the thrombus to propagate, but the solution is going to be dissolved in some moment, spontaneously. Unless the patient has hypotensive, a massive pulmonary embolism, and hypertrophy of the right ventricle. If we have this, we give antithrombolytic also. And for long-term prevention, would be warfarin or inhibitors of the thrombin, dabigatran or dabigatran, and this patient, all the patient with pulmonary embolism present with chest pain, could be pleuritic, could increase with cough or respiration, sneezing, dyspnea, tachycardia, palpitations. And hemoptysis. We are going to touch hemoptysis in a while. Hemoptysis means that besides the pulmonary embolism, we have infarction of the lung. So the algorithm is: we have this patient with these symptoms. Then we do Wells criteria. Wells criteria is symptoms or signs of pulmonary embolism, 3 points. Pulmonary embolism is the most likely diagnosis, 3 points. Surgery in the last month or traumatic problem in the last month or immobilization more than 3 days, it is 1.5 points. Tachycardia, 1.5 points. Hemoptysis, 1 point. Malignancy, 1 point. These are 11 points. If we have more than 4 points, it is likely pulmonary embolism. If we have less, it is not very likely. This is the quick schema. We used to do the 6 points, lower than 6 points high risk, between 2 and 6 medium risk, and less than 2 low risk. So, first, if the patient can be on anticoagulation, we do Wells criteria and we continue to see this. If the patient cannot go on anticoagulation, so we do that diagnostic testing that I'm going to mention. First, in the diagnostic testing is, if the patient has Wells criteria less than 4, we do CT scan. If the patient has, greater than 4. If the patient has less than 4, we are going to give chance. First, we do the measure of the D-dimers, the fibrillation product. If these are greater than 500, we continue, and this CT scan is the next. If this is less than 500, we exclude pulmonary embolism. This is very sensitive but non-specific, so we have a very high negative predictive value. So if it is less, we exclude it. If it is high, we don't know, and so we continue with CT scan. Here, because pulmonary embolism is likely, because it's, the points were more than 4, we just go to the CT scan and we don't wait to have the dimers. Alright, so now, if the patient can go to anticoagulation, we do Wells criteria. If Wells criteria, we have high risk, this is more than 6 points, we anticoagulate immediately. And then we do the verification. Could be CT scan later. Here, if the patient is low to medium risk, we do the diagnostic criteria, that was this, first taking the dimers and then the CT scan. But if we cannot do this before 4 hours, even though we don't know and it is low risk, we anticoagulate immediately. If then, in the confirmation, we confirm the diagnosis, so we continue anticoagulation. If not, we discontinue the anticoagulation if we needed to give anticoagulation because the diagnosis was unable to perform before 4 hours. If the patient cannot go on anticoagulation, we do just the diagnostic criteria of the dimers and the CT scan. If the patient does not, if we exclude pulmonary embolism, no anticoagulation. If the patient is confirmed to have a pulmonary embolism, we do a filter IVC vein. Inferior vena cava. But this is because we cannot give the anticoagulation. And also, this patient can have in chest X-ray, we can have watermaker sign, that is a collapse or atelectasis of the distal alveoli distal to the pulmonary embolism, or we can have Hampton-Home sign, that is a infarction wedge-shaped infarction of the lung, and this is going to present clinically with hemoptysis. And if the patient has recurrent pulmonary embolism, The patient can have hypertrophy of the right ventricle because of increased pressure. But if the patient has just an acute pulmonary embolism, the patient is going to have increased cavity size of the pulmon- of the right ventricle, not yet the wall thickness. And also because we have less blood flow that is going to the lungs, then we have less blood flow that is arriving again to the right and left atrium. And so next, less blood to the left ventricle, and so we have weak pulses and diminished pressure. And also, this patient can have in the thrombus, can have something called the SAN lines. This is lines that alternate between pink and red. Pink is fibrin and platelets, and red are red blood cells. This we only would see it if the thrombus is in pre-mortem. If the patient already dies and we see the thrombus, we will not see line SAN. So in a thrombus, we can distinguish if the patient is alive or dead, or at least dead so long time ago, or could be alive or dead, but very little. That the death happened very little time. If we see line SAN, the thrombus was formed pre-mortem, and if we don't see line SAN, was formed post-mortem.